Let's go back to our reporter Annie Puller now. Angela, who's just outside the shopping centre. Obviously, as the evening's gone on, the operation has been one to try and get some calm return to that area, the 3,000 or so shoppers and staff members who had to be evacuated, and trying to just get some clarity about what has happened there. So what is the latest there, Annie?
Yeah, Michael, I can just tell you I'm in touch now with a friend of that mother who has passed away in hospital. She tells me that family members are making their way to Sydney from all over the country, and they are just hoping and praying tonight her little baby makes it through. We know that that nine-month-old did get rushed into emergency surgery, still waiting on a condition update there, but this is truly horrific what has unfolded inside this shopping centre. We've been showing you very distressing pictures, harrowing and heartbreaking scenes throughout the night. But just standing here, it's quite eerie at the moment. Everyone has dispersed. Many of the witnesses who were here have headed home, and really there is just this silence. Standing here, knowing what unfolded just a few metres away, is simply horrific. This store here, Camilla and Mark, we spoke to some of the store members who were in there. They tell me that they were hiding in a storeroom, and they had watched this armed man go up and down the escalator. We've seen that incredible vision of a guy who I'm told was actually yelling out in Russian, "Step away, step away." He was the one holding the bollards there, trying to prevent him from moving any further. So just so many stories of bravery coming out today, not to mention that a senior female officer who confronted this attacker head on and managed to bring this situation under control. Michael and Ange, you can see it's still an active crime scene as we go to where we know that this is going to look like this for some time. I'm told that the shopping centre will unlikely be open early tomorrow morning. Police have sort of brought in more resources tonight. They're really setting up here. No doubt there'll be a command post as officers inside continue to scour for any evidence. The Raptor squad have now left, but there's still detectives. There's also still a few of those store members who are giving witness statements. Many have told me that they're exhausted, emotionally drained, and really struggling from the scenes that they've seen. I just observed some video earlier, and there were people in store when this attacker was shot down in the centre. They witnessed the entire thing. That female police officer did try to perform CPR. They did try to keep him alive, but he died. We're still trying to find out more details about who this man is and what his motive is, but Michael and Ange, no doubt that will all come out in the coming days.
Annie, one question, and I'm not sure you have the answer, so I ask it probably unfairly, but the one thing I haven't heard in all the coverage this afternoon from all the eyewitnesses that you've spoken to, many of them were close, they did see it. Has anyone reported that this attacker made any statements, any words? Was anything said as he was running through the shopping centre, enacting this carnage? In some of the vision we just saw then, in fact, as I'm saying this question, it looks like he did leap towards someone. Did anybody hear him say anything along the way?
This is the strangest thing, speaking to so many people who saw him in motion. They say that he was kind of stone-faced. There was no words being ushered. He was simply acting erratically, moving around, lunging towards different people as they managed to get out of the way. Really bizarre to see a man like that on a rampage, not yelling, not screaming, almost kind of walking quite calmly, but committing something that is just so horrific. To think what sort of state of mind that man would have been in, we really don't know, and it's almost impossible to comprehend considering the lives that have been lost inside this centre. But Michael, yeah, that is a really resounding thing that we're hearing, that no one heard this accused attacker usher a single word, and he certainly made his way through several levels. It'll be interesting to see where he actually entered the shopping centre, if he was carrying that machete when he went in. Obviously, the first that many customers heard of this is when they saw him actually carrying it. At what point did he bring that out? We still don't know. It was just after 4 o'clock when the chaos started to unfold. This centre closes here at about 5 o'clock on a Saturday. So whether this was a strategic move, whether it was premeditated, planned, this will all form part of the police investigation. But certainly just harrowing scenes when you consider how busy this centre is. It's my local, and just standing here seeing the sheer terror that's come out of here today is truly upsetting. So many people on social media, I've just had a look then on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, just sharing their disbelief at the scenes here today. So many people really want answers, Michael. I know we will be hearing from the commissioner at 8:30, so in about 10 minutes, no doubt police will be working around the clock to establish what the motive was here.
Oh, no, we don't have an MCI.
Annie, you've covered a lot of crime in Sydney. I was intrigued when the assistant commissioner came out earlier and said that at 3:10 the attacker went into the Bondi Junction Westfield, then left, came back 10 minutes later. Mm. What they didn't clarify then and there is whether or not he had the knife in the first place and went back to get the knife. It's a minor point at this stage, but I would imagine in your experience in reporting these, they're being guided at that point with that information by security vision. Some officer would have gone straight to the hub at Westfield and started scanning the cameras, I'd imagine.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, when you consider how big this shopping centre is, take a look at it. It is, you know, surveillance central. There would be cameras on every corner, in every alleyway, in every laneway, no doubt. This man has definitely been captured on security video, and that will be a big focus for detectives inside tonight. Also considering that this man, it sounds like he went into several stores, and that is where he engaged with some of his victims. So all of these stores will have cameras, a really distressing sight for these officers who have also just turned up to work today to have to confront this. And just speaking to some of them, a local police officer who I know just texted me said in all his years working in Bondi, he really hasn't seen anything as horrific as this. And I think they feel a sense of duty tonight to give answers to the community, to ensure that they know what happened here, and also to call for calm. We know that the threat is over, that the community are not in danger anymore, but this will really affect public safety in the area. You can only imagine people will probably be terrified coming back to work tomorrow, considering that they saw what they saw today. So part of the police process, I guess, is making sure that the community know that this isn't something that regularly happens at a shopping centre like this, and just making sure that they tame the situation, that it doesn't get out of control, and especially that, you know, the facts are reported, that there's no misinformation circulating in this community, who will no doubt really want answers as to how this has all happened.
Just very briefly, Annie, too, before we let you go, because we've got some more statements we're going to get to, but, you know, our hearts are sinking tonight and have sunk for all of the victims, those who have been severely wounded, but obviously particularly for the family that have lost their 38-year-old, the mum, and the little baby who is in the hospital. I'm also thinking deeply of the victims or the witnesses that you spoke to this afternoon who saw all of this. Annie, I mean, there's one woman in particular you spoke to who saw it all right up close, did their best to help.
Yeah, and I think that's what they're feeling tonight. Is you would know in doing this job for so many years, Michael, that people see something but they don't quite process it straight away. It's not until they sit back that they possibly watch the video that we've been airing all night that they really realise and comprehend what has happened here. You've also got to spare a thought tonight, Michael, for all of those families who are waiting for answers at various hospitals across Sydney, wondering if their loved ones are going to pull through. Just looking at you know, photos of this young mum who has lost her life, She looked like she spent a lot of time in the Bondi community. She'd recently become a mum, and, you know, I'm just thinking of her husband right now, waiting to hear the news about whether his little baby girl is okay. He's lost his wife. Now he's waiting in limbo to find out if his daughter is going to survive. Just couldn't even imagine it. Michael?
Just heartbreaking.
No, it's just too hard to imagine, Annie. Well said there.